بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Dear respected viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program Towards the Origin. Watch live on channel Sky 7344. To all of those who have joined with us through our Facebook channel, thank you very much. And inshallah, this program will also be repeated on the following day. And later on, you can also find us on our YouTube channel. Our tonight's discussion will be on the topic wastage. We all know half term is on. And inshallah, commencing from perhaps tomorrow and the whole next week, a lot of weddings, a lot of events that we will be attending. And one of the things that we do notice in those events, in whatever, whether it be the wedding events, whether it be the reception events, or whatever community events we're talking about, there's always one thing we do notice: wastage of food. What about those who are involved in the power, in the position of influence? How do they utilize those positions? How do we waste those positions, the power in those positions? And in general, the time that we waste in our daily life. As Muslim, how responsible or how much responsible should we be in terms of looking after not only the wastage of food, not only the wastage of money, but also the wastage of time, and in general, wastage in general overall. All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll try and discuss in our tonight's discussion. But before we proceed, the formalities must be proceeded with. We've been joined by our regular guest, who is the respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known Mosque, London Islamic Centre, the Regent's Park Mosque, which is famously known. He's also a graduate of Al-Azhar University, Fadilatul Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Welcome to the program.
You're welcome, Brother Qamar.
Let's start. Even though the title is wastage, very simple, some people might be just tuning in and be wondering, what a small one-word topic.
Yep.
Why did you choose that?
طيب. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين وَمَنْ تَبِعَهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ ثُمَّ مَا بَعْدٍ. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah, the Almighty. We normally say that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created us as human beings in order to test us, to trial us, to see which one of us are good in terms of the righteous deeds. So we are actually in a life which is known as the life of test. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala confirms in the Noble Quran when he says, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. So Allah the Almighty says that when ablukum, that we test you, we trial you. Ami tumaderke hey manob, hey manushkon. Ami tumaderke amra, ami tumaderke porikka kori. When ablukum bisharri, tumaderke karab jinish de porikka kori. We test you with obviously like bad things, like through calamities, difficulties, and khair. And also we test you through goodness, by giving you the good things. অর্থাৎ তোমাদেরকে আমি পরীক্ষা করে ভালো জিনিস দিয়ে এবং খারাপ জিনিস দিয়ে পরীক্ষা কিন্তু দুটো জিনিস দিয়ে হতে পারে.
Now before we proceed, আমি এখানে একটা জিনিস জানতে যাচ্ছি. When you say ভালো জিনিস দিয়ে পরীক্ষা করেন, একটু যদি elaborate করেন, what do you mean by that?
Yes, so normally we understand that test is just like illnesses, it could be calamities, difficulties, failure.
It's
a test. But we don't realize that the test could be also through a good life, through a lot of money, through many children. Through a beautiful life. This can
beautiful
be also
children.
Test. Yeah, children. And this could be a form of test as well. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً, that we test you with the goodness and with the bad things, fitna, and this is a trial for you, fitna. وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ, and every one of you will return to me. You will come back to me. তোমরা সবাই কিন্তু আমার দিকে ফিরে আসতে হবে.
Now, এখানে যখন আপনি বলছেন goodness, বা যখন এখানে নেয়ামতের কথা যখন আপনি বলছেন, একটি জিনিস আমরা ভুলে যাই, when we are talking about ni'ama, without iman, are these considered to be ni'ama?
No, so first of all, iman, of course, has to be there. Then we say is test. And then, of course, like how this ni'mah can be a test. So the life of a believer is based upon one of the two concepts. Whether it's a sabr, patience, if life is difficult, then it's patient. And if life is easy and beautiful and comfortable, then shukr. So whether we are in patience or in gratitude, either way, we cannot, a believer's life, the life of a believer is based upon sabr and shukr, gratitude and patience. So if we do have the good things, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to see us how we've been grateful, how we're spending, how we're dealing with those ni'mah.
Now, bounties. That's true. But the other point you've mentioned, I've been bulletin patience. Now, এখন আমি যদি একটা এক্সাম্পল দেই এই হলিডে সিজন আসছে অনেক মানুষ কিন্তু উমরায় যাবে ওয়াদা করা হয়েছে দ্যাট দে উইল বি গেটিং দিস সর্ট অফ প্যাকেজেস বাট দেন দে ফাউন্ড আউট দ্যাট দে হ্যাভ বিন গিভেন কমপ্লিটলি ডিফারেন্ট পারহ্যাপস দি লোয়েস্ট স্ট্যান্ডার্ড দ্যান হোয়াট দে ওয়ার এক্সপেক্টেড এখন আপনাকে বলা হচ্ছে সবর করেন ভাই আপনি হজে আসছেন
নো দ্যাটস নট রাইট অফ কোর্স দেয়ার হ্যাজ টু বি সাম সর্ট অফ অনেস্টি এন্ড ট্রুথফুলনেস ইন বিজনেসেস এন্ড দিস ক্যান বি ডান অফ কোর্স উই আফটার উই ট্রাই এভরিথিং দেন ইফ এনিথিং গোজ রং দেন উই ডু সবর আমরা প্রচেষ্টা করার পরে যদি কোনো কিছু আমাদের মানুষ আমাদের মন অনুযায়ী না হয় মন মাফিক না হয় তখন আমাদেরকে সবর করতে হবে কিন্তু জাস্ট পিপল can't just overrun. People just can't do whatever they like. You have to also be vigilant and you have to be careful.
তার মানে হচ্ছে আমি intentionally করেছি একটি জিনিস তারপরে বলছি আরেকজনকে ভাই সবর করে ফেলেন দ্যাট ইজ নট অ্যালাউড
নো দ্যাটস নট রাইট ওকে দ্যাটস নট রাইট ওকে সো নাও কামিং ব্যাক টু দ্য লাইফ অফ বিলিভার ওয়ান আব্লুকুম বিশাররি ওয়াল খাইরি ফিতনা উই টেস্ট ইউ আমি তোমাদেরকে পরীক্ষা করি ভালো জিনিস দিয়ে এবং খারাপ জিনিস দিয়ে ওইটাই না তোর যাউন সবাই তোমরা কিন্তু আমার দিকে ফিরে আসতে হবে নাও টকিং অ্যাবাউট ওয়েস্টেজ অ্যান্ড এক্সট্রাভেগেন্স অর্থাৎ আমরা এটাকে অপচয় বলতে পারি ইসরাফ বলতে পারি বাংলা ভাষায় বা আমরা আরবি শব্দ যে ইসরাফটা এটাও কিন্তু প্রসিদ্ধ অনেকে ইসরাফটা বুঝে ফেলেন বা তাবজিরও অনেকে বলে থাকেন
না এখানে একটা যখন আপনি যখন ইউজ করছেন ইসরাফ এখানে সাধারণত মানুষের একটি ধারণা আছে ফর এক্সাম্পল আল্লাহ যদি কাউকে হালাল সোর্সে ক্যাপাসিটি দিয়েছেন সে হয়তো লাক্সারি কার কিনতে পারবে বা লাক্সারি একটা হাউস বা ঘর কিনতে পারবে ওয়ার এজ আরেকজন হয়তো তার তৌফিক অনুমান সে ঘর কিনছে না যার তৌফিক আছে সে যদি লাক্সারি ঘর বা লাক্সারি গাড়ি ফ্রম হালাল সোর্স যদি কিনে থাকে উড ইউ কল দ্যাট অ্যাজ এন এক্সাম্পল
ইয়েস উই আর কামিং টু দিস নাও ইয়েস দিস ইজ অ্যান ইম্পর্টেন্ট পয়েন্ট সো আল ইসরাফ উই নো ইন দ্য কোরআনিক term, or the Quran is puri bashay, that israf bola hoche, wastage ba opochoy kora, excessive kora, otironjon kora, shimalongon kora, transgression, crossing the bounds, crossing the limits, and going beyond the limits. It's known as al-israf in Quran al-Kareem. So the scholars of tafsir, they say, al-israf wa tajawuz al-had fi kulli fi'lin ma yaf'aluhu al-insan. So israf is crossing the bounds or the limits, whatever a human being might be doing. So it could be, israf could be in power, excessive power, implementing power. Israf could be in food. Israf could be in wasting the mal, the wealth, the money. It could be also in all things. Whatever is excessive is known as israf, in general, talking about al-israf. So the scholars of tafsir say, وَهِيَ تَجَاوز هُوَ تَجَاوزُ الْحَدِّ فِي كُلِّ فِعْلٍ يَفْعَلُهُ الْإِنسَانِ Whatever a believer or human being does and he crossed the bounds, known as israf. وهو في الانفاق اشهر but it is more well known in when it comes to spending or that israf shabdota jodio generally byabohar kora hoye thake kintu eta spending er moddhe bear moddhe kintu eta beshi prosiddho huwa fil infaq ashhar yaqulu ta'ala allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the noble quran very famous verse ya bani adam hey adam shuntan gon o children of adam khudhu zinatakum inda kulli masjid that take beautify yourself, adorn yourself, cover yourself, the necessity, awra, cover yourself when you go to the masajid, the buyutullah, the houses of Allah the Almighty. And now nowadays you see how people go to masjid. We normally say masjid should be given a lot of concentration. And many of us I've seen, we go to masjid with some sort of stinky clothes, like smell of curry, smell of
smokes. The most least wanted yes, clothes that yes. you perhaps would never wear to anywhere else, people, you would find them in the masjid.
Exactly.
In
and,
general.
And in general. I must say, আমাদের কমিউনিটিতে আমাদের যে মসজিদ গুলো আছে আমাদের মসজিদ গুলো কিন্তু আরো উন্নত করতে হবে অর্থাৎ আমরা যখন মসজিদে ঢুকি তখন মসজিদের যে স্মেলটা আছে And
cleanliness, hygiene.
Exactly. Mm. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الملائكة تتأذى بما تتأذى به بنو آدم. Or that فرشتروا كنتو كوستوبان جتا مانوب شنطان دا جدنش تاكي كوستوبان Or that درغنتو تاكي فرشتروا كوستوبان.
So
even the angels are harmed by the bad smells and the bad odor. So يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد should be given at high importance.
Now why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in this verse, Ya Bani Adam? Why did he not use Ya Ayyuhan Nas? Why O Bani Adam?
Absolutely. So it's an important question. Bani Adam, the children of Adam, is an address for the whole entire mankind. So the children of Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses different khitab. Sometimes he says, Ya Ayyuhan Nas, mankind. Sometimes children of Adam. Very similar, but it's a very general call upon the whole entire humanity. Children of Adam, we are all part of the Adamic family, or the Adam. Alayhi Islamir Puribar Amra Ongsho Ebong Amra member Amra Shadosho. Ya Bani Adam, hey Adam Shuntan Gontumra, Jokon Masjid Jabe Tokontumra Shundor Kapor Puridan Korejabe. Zina, in the Kulli Masjid, Tarbura Alapakrabul Alamin, Wakuru Ashrabu. Alapakrabul Alamin, he is allowing us and permitting us to eat. He's saying, Kulu, eat, Washrabu, and drink. So Kul, Akal, and Shurb. Is allowed, permissible, not only just permissible, but they're needed, and sometimes they can be even compulsory. وَكُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا Eat and drink. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the conditions. He gives some sort of guidelines. And nowadays people say, you're all free, like people are free, they can do whatever they like. But actually there's nothing, you know, absolutely secular or nothing absolutely free. There has to be some sort of right and wrong. There has to be some sort
guideline,
of guidelines. Guidelines, yes, okay. Of course. Very, very important.
Now, before we proceed, when you talked about beautification of masjid, now you can ekti atena kiamatar alamat onuji. Please correct me. Kiamatar ekti alamat hoto je masjid shundor theke shundor hoye jabe kintu musallire thakbe na.
This is another problem. Yes, and we find a lot of masjid
have been beautified,
highly decorated. However, there's not many musallis, and we find this in many parts of the world. But masjid should be ta'mir al masajid. It should be activated with different activities, the activities of durus, the halaqat of Quran, the circles of Quran, circles of knowledge, and that's how the masjid should be utilized. The center of da'wah, center of like judgment, counseling, and serving
many
people.
Other sectors,
yes,
shop
yes,
service.
Yes, yes.
Tarmani otse, beautification of masjid is not a problem. But as because some as, people would yep. think that maybe that's one of the indication of alama
no,
of the qiyamah.
I mean, what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam disliked is that you beautify excessively, again, extravagance. Exactly.
And
extravagance again is not allowed. So you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the guideline. He said, Wakulu, eat, washrabu, drink. But he's saying, Wala tusrifu, but don't waste. Don't be extravagant. Opoche korona, tumra shima longon korona. Tumra shima otikrom korona. Wala tusrifu innahu la yuhibbul musrifin. Why? Because verily Allah the Almighty doesn't like the people who waste. Allah doesn't like the people who waste. Or Allah pak rabbul alamin oi byakti ke balobashena je byakti opochoy kore taken otironjon kore taken shimalangon kore taken.
Now ekhon ei shimalangoner definition eta kothay ami kothoruk bolbo je amar jonno eta hocche shimalangon ba is it a general barrier, or is it? It depends on every individual. Tar obosthan ujayi tar ekta.
Excellent. Yes. Now. Yes. Now. Very important. Ibn Abbas, rahimahullah, a great scholar of tafsir amongst the Sahaba, or the Sahaba karam radhiyallahu anhu, the tonto ekjon guruttopurno Sahabi Ibn Abbas, Abdullah Ibn Abbas radhiyallahu anhu, uni bolen. Ahallallahu al-akla wa-shurb. Or that Allah pak rabbul alamin kanadana ebong. Pan korake halal korechen. He permitted eating and drinking, right? Ma lam yakun sirfan aw makhila, as long as there is not any extravagance, as long as there is any wastage, and there is not any pride. Now, sometimes people eat just because people prepare the food just to show pride. You know, people prepare so much food. You see, like in some places.
When you say prepare food, is it johon mehman ashe ja nijer jonno?
No, mehmaner jonno. Jokhon manusher ke mane eta ektu mane projection korar jonno, manusher ke dekhanor jonno. Some people like they make lots, and you find that in many parts of the world. Unfortunately,
now, that's true. Having said that, but then the other side is after jodi erokom mehmane jodi khatirdari na koren, then the other side of it, they say, mane manush johon bolbe that I have been as a guest, but least they could
I've been
served respectfully.
No, I mean if people have the right right understanding of the religion and the teaching of Quran and Hadith, then I don't think that should be an issue.
আচ্ছা এখানে আবার একটা কথা সেপারেটে বলতে চাই, যার তৌফিক আছে সে যদি করে এবং খাওয়া যদি ওয়েস্ট না হয়, ইন কম্পারিজন টু যার তৌফিক নাই পার সে টাকা ঋণ করে বা লোনের মধ্যে করে করছে.
So now yes, we are coming to now you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also he gives us another guideline. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fa inna Allah yuhibbu an yara ni'matahu ala 'abdihi. Now everybody must be spending according to his capacity. This is another important thing.
Achha.
Now this is where the balance comes. If one of us is really আমাদের মধ্যে যদি কেউ আলহামদুলিল্লাহ আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিন আমাদেরকে মাল সম্পদ দিয়ে থাকেন, তখন আমাদের স্পেন্ডিংটা হবে ওই আমাদের মাল অনুযায়ী, আমাদের সম্পদ অনুযায়ী. দিস ইজ ওয়াট প্রফেসর আসাম টেলিং আস. আমাদের প্রিয় মুহাম্মদ আমাদেরকে বলছেন যে আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিন কোনো মানুষকে যদি নিয়ামত দিয়ে থাকেন, তখন ওই নিয়ামতের আসরটা, নিয়ামতের যে প্রমাণটা উনি ওনার জীবনের মধ্যে দেখতে চান. Very important as well.
Achha.
So now if somebody is blessed with wealth, then Allah the Almighty wants to see some signs of that blessing in his life. So if someone's Allah, if Allah gave you mal, if Allah gave you money, then just don't buy a car maybe 300-400 pounds. Allah gave you enough money, so you buy something like this moderate, something that's you can afford and it's good.
So money to balance the strike the balance between my stinginess and excessive
and extravagance. Wastage, yes.
Now এখন এখানে যদি আরেকটা কথা হচ্ছে যে কেউ হয়তো চাচ্ছে যে ঠিক আছে আমি সেভ করছি, আমি for me I don't want that.
Now yes, again this is we must save, but that doesn't mean that I normally say it's easy to be Muslim, but it's very difficult to be a balanced Muslim. ভারসাম্যতাকে কিন্তু মেনটেন করা কিন্তু ইটস নট ইজি জব, এন্ড দিস ইজ দ্য রিজন ওয়াই উই হ্যাভ টু কিপ ইন টাচ উইথ দ্য বিগ স্কলার্স অফ ইসলাম লাইক ফোকাহা, দ্য জুরিস্ট, দ্য গুড রিয়েলি কোয়ালিফাইড স্কলার্স, উই হ্যাভ টু কিপ ইন টাচ উইথ দেম. আনলেস উই কিপ ইন টাচ উইথ দোজ স্কলার্স, দেন উই ক্যান ইজিলি গো রং অ্যান্ড উই ক্যান লুজ আওয়ার ব্যালেন্স. সো we'll misunderstand things, we'll misunderstand the text of Quran, we'll misunderstand the text of Hadith. আমরা কিন্তু ইজিলি আমাদের মধ্যে ভুল বুঝেবুঝে এসে যেতে পারে, অ্যান্ড এই জন্য আমরা কিন্তু আমাদেরকে কোয়ালিফাইড আলিমদের সাথে আমাদের সম্পর্ক রাখতে হবে সর্বদা.
না এখানে কোয়ালিফাইড আলিম, আল কাম টু দ্যাট লেটার. নাও দেয়ার ইজ অ্যানাদার ভার্স, আল্লাহ যখন বললেন করা ওয়া আম্মা বি নি'মাতি রাব্বিকা ফাহাদ্দিস, একটু আপনি যদি একটু
এখানে টাচ করেন ওয়া আম্মা বি নি'মাতি রাব্বিকা ফাহাদ্দিস, এটা অর্থ হচ্ছে যে আপনাকে যদি আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিন কোনো নিয়ামত দিয়ে থাকেন, তখন আপনি আপনার বন্ধুবান্ধব, আপনার আত্মীয়স্বজনদের সাথে আপনি কিছু আলোচনা করতে পারেন উইদাউট হ্যাভিং এনি প্রাইড, কোনো অহংকার এবং গৌরব না রেখে,
শফ না দেখে,
শফ না রেখে আপনি শুধু আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিনের ফজল এবং করম আপনি বর্ণনা করতে পারেন. হ্যাঁ আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আমাকে এরকম দিয়েছেন, এরকম হয়েছে. আমরা কিন্তু সাম পিপল আর ভেরি সেন্সিটিভ, দে সে ও as long even if you say something, share a good news, they say, oh, this is pride, don't say it, it's show off.
Okay.
Don't say it. Some people again they become a bit of harsh, but we should again allow people to share the good news and good stuff and good things
but
in
then,
life.
But then when we've got a third opinion, then manush will be don't share too much to a certain individual or to those people, there's something called as evil eye.
Yeah, now again this is just to be careful, people take some sort of cautiousness, and that's okay. Again, too much shouldn't be done. We shouldn't show too much. But at the same time, if just somebody says something something good in life, doesn't mean that something bad will happen.
In context.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. I mean, also it has to be again in a very balanced way. So just because you say something good, that doesn't mean that you'll be affected, because at the end of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the protector. And as long as you maintain your du'as, your masnoon du'as, then Allah is the protector.
And that's true. And the other side of it as well, khali shampud share korana, ekhon amra dekhi. But I think it's been a custom or culture that if we know someone influential, if we know someone politically very powerful, if we know someone financially very powerful, we tend to drop some names in the conversation. Je omuk to ami chini, omuk amar bondhu, ba omuk ami oi MP ke ami chini, oi minister ke ami chini.
Yes, so sometimes you find
photo session, selfie theke shuru hoye jay.
And you find sometimes people subhanallah, I've seen people they just go and keep on saying, I've met this person today, I've met that person today.
That's true.
I've spoken to this person, I was with this individual. These are all, there's no need for these things. لا يعني من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعني. Part of the beautiful character of trait of a Muslim is to avoid that something that important, not beneficial. So what's going to happen? It doesn't matter how many people, even the whole entire population in UK knows you, then people in Bangladesh might not know you. If people, whole entire nation in Bangladesh knows you, then people here may not know you. So no matter how famous you become in this world, you still be unknown. You know, you cannot become an absolutely famous person. The most famous people in this world are unknown as well to many people. So, orthat absolutely kono mashhur ba prasiddhota labh kora kintu shombhob noy. No matter how famous we become, but we're still unknown to some people. The most important thing that we are, whether we are known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not, whether we are recognized to our Creator, Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, coming back to again, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يَرَى نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. Allah the Almighty, He wants to see the sign of the ni'mah in the life of a believer. And then now, again, this extravagance, this wasting can be in food. And a lot of us, many of us actually, we eat excessive food. And of course, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he gives us the guidelines when it comes to consuming the food. And nowadays, unfortunately, we have incredible amount of the shopping centers, malls, and supermarkets. And when you get into the supermarket, you see the amount of food, subhanAllah, like you just feel like buying. And once you're in it, inside the center, you just want to buy more and more.
আর এই জন্য এখন দেখা যাচ্ছে স্পেশালি ইফ ইউ লুক এট দ্য ইউকে স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্স এন্ড সার্ভে ওবেসিটি ইজ ওয়ান অফ দি মোস্ট ডেঞ্জারাস হেলথ ইস্যু that takes you towards closer to the death.
Exactly.
And it's one of the reasons, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I'll double check it again, they're saying after cancer, one of the most very, very serious illnesses and needs to be tackled.
And consumption of food is the root to all problem. Excessive and extravagance in eating and consuming the food.
And when you say extravagant, we see unnecessary khawa. মানে কোনো দরকার নাই, খিদা নাই, just খাওয়ার সামনে আছে বলেই আমি খাচ্ছি.
And this is the reason why it says that, you know, to eat for the sake of enjoyment, and just to taste, a lot of scholars dislike tea. অনেক ওলামারা এটা কিন্তু অপছন্দ মনে করেছেন যে extra just to taste the food.
My dear viewers, আমরা শুনছিলাম আলোচনা on the topic wastage, and Sheikh has very clearly explained in context what wastage means and how can we refrain. Islam does not prohibit us from enjoying the luxury that Allah has blessed us with. It's just we have to channel it in correct order, in correct parameters, within the boundaries that Allah has given us, and enjoy those ni'mah, and also not to forget those who are less financially able or less socially able, let's not deprive them. Alhamdulillah, there's a lot of khair within our community. Allah has blessed us with tremendous amount of ni'mah, whether it be the wealth, whether it be the education, whether it be the political influence Allah has blessed us with, is how we channel them. And inshallah, in our next segment, we'll be continuing this discussion, and we'll be touching mostly about the food, wastage in food, wastage in weddings, an excessive amount of money that's been spent in things that perhaps could be saved and utilized for something else. Inshallah, do stay tuned with us. We'll be right back in a few moments. Wassalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, welcome back after the break. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, who is a respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known Mosque, Regent's Park Mosque, and also a graduate of Al-Azhar University. Our tonight's discussion is on the topic wastage, and we've discussed in the first segment about different forms of wastage, whether it be through the food, whether it be through the wealth, whether it be through other activities that perhaps we could have utilized it in a better way. Inshallah, in this segment, we'll be discussing about not only the food, the upcoming weddings and the events that we see within our society, and what about natural resources? What about water? All of this, inshallah, we'll try and touch in this segment. You can email us if you've got any suggestion, any question, please feel free. The email address is at the bottom of your TV screen, which is towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. Also, this program is repeated on the following day, and later on, you'll also find us on our YouTube channel. Now, Sheikh, going back to the discussion, you've talked about wastage of food. Yeah. Now, there are certain people would say, if Allah has given me ni'mah, why should I not enjoy the food?
Yeah.
Well, they would have an argument that, alhamdulillah, I'm physically fit. I have no issues with overweight or any other concern with the weight. And I have access to a different sort of food from different continent, and Allah has given me the ni'mah.
Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Again, we've been talking about, just a reminder, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tests us with good things and bad things in this life. And some of us, we don't even realize, actually, we commit a lot of sins and we commit some major mistakes and crimes in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we don't realize. One of them is wastage, extravagance, opochoy, shimalangon, shima otikrom. এই জিনিসগুলো কিন্তু আমরা অনুভব করি না আমরা আমরা এগুলোকে আমরা কিন্তু আমরা সিরিয়াসলি আমরা দেখি না বাট অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিজ আর সোর্সেস অফ সিনস অ্যান্ড মাআসি অ্যাকর্ডিং টু আল্লাহ তাবারাকা ওয়া তাআলা So we don't realize that wastage and extravagance is sinful. And with regards to obviously the food that you've mentioned, now you may not look very big in size, but actually it can be unhealthy.
I'm just making sure, obviously, we're not saying anything against anyone who
individual.
Has any individual or perhaps who has got medical reasons or health reasons. We are not talking about any of those individuals. We're talking in general, Zara, due to unnecessary, excessive consumptions of food.
And there is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's an instruction on this specific subject, the excessive consumption of food. Hadith is on the authority of Imam Ahmad. Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, he says the Prophet said, "Ma mala ibnu Adam wi'a sharra min batnihi." A child of Adam cannot fill up a vessel which is worse than his stomach. Wi'a sharra min batnihi. So he cannot like fill up a container or like a vessel worse, something worse than his own stomach. And then Prophet said, if he has to eat, then what he should do? Look at this beautiful instruction of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says that فَثُلُثٌ لِطَعَامِهِ, one third for food, وَثُلُثٌ لِشَرَابِهِ, one third for drink, وَثُلُثٌ لِنَفَسِهِ, and one third for breathing. Or the Rasulullah Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam bolchen je kono boni Adam, Adam shantan kono jinish jodi poripurno fill up korte chay tahole batan ortat pet theke emon kono kharap jinish noy to fill up something. প্যাট থেকে খারাপ কোনো জিনিস হতে পারে না ইন অর্ডার টু ফিল আপ পরিপূর্ণ করার জন্য তারপর উনি বলেন যদি কেউ এটাকে পরিপূর্ণ করতে হয় অর্থাৎ খেতে হয় ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ টু ইট দেন ওয়ান থার্ড এক তৃতীয়াংশ খাবার জন্য এক তৃতীয়াংশ পান করার জন্য এবং এক তৃতীয়াংশ ব্রিদিং করার জন্য অর্থাৎ
খালি ভ্যাকিউম
এয়ার এর জন্য কিন্তু এই জিনিসটা কিন্তু রাসূল কারীম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ওয়ান অফ দ্য ভেরি গ্রেট টিচিং অফ প্রফেসর সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম এন্ড সাম অফ দ্য এক্সপার্টস ইন মেডিকেল এন্ড হেলথ সেক্টরস দে সেড দিস হাদিস ইজ রিয়েলি ইটস এ পার্ল ইটস এন ইম্পর্ট্যান্ট হাদিস এটা কিন্তু খুবই গুরুত্বপূর্ণ হাদিস এই হাদিসটাকে আমরা যদি মেনে চলতে পারতাম তাহলে আজকে আমাদের অনেক গুরুত্বপূর্ণ উল্লেখযোগ্য অঙ্কের আমাদের যে ইলনেসগুলো আছে এগুলো কমে যেত
না এখানে আরেকটি জিনিস আছে মেডিকেল সায়েন্স এটাও বলছে যে ওয়ান অফ দি ওয়েজ ইউ ক্যান স্টে ওয়েল ইজ ফাস্টিং টু ডেইজ আর আমরা জানি টু ডেইজ এ উইক আর আমরা এটাও জানি যে রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম কিন্তু প্রত্যেক সপ্তাহে কিন্তু দুদিন কিন্তু রোজা রাখতেন সো দ্য সুন্নাহ ইজ নাও দ্য মেডিকেল সায়েন্স ইজ কনফার্মিং দ্য সুন্নাহ
এন্ড ইয়েস দ্যাটস রাইট এন্ড ইভেন প্রফেসর সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম হি ডিসলাইকড কনজিউমিং এক্সসেসিভ মিটস বিকজ প্রফেসর সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম সেড লাইক মিট হ্যাজ অ্যান অ্যাডিকশন ইন ইট অর্থাৎ আসলে মাংসের মধ্যে নেশা আছে যখন আমরা মানে রেগুলার মাংস খেতে থাকি এটা কিন্তু সোর্স অফ ইলনেসেস এবং ডক্টররা এগুলো ভালো বলতে পারবেন সো প্রফেসর আসাম ডিসলাইক ইটিং এক্সেসিভ মিটস অ্যাজ ওয়েল সো দে উড হ্যাভ মেবি ওয়ান্স ইন এ মান্থ ও ওয়াট টুয়াইস ইন এ মান্থ অ্যান্ড দ্যাটস হাউ দে উড কনসিউম দ্য মিট বাট উই হ্যাভ মেনি পিপল লাইক সো আই হ্যাভ হার্ড পিপল সেইং মানে মাংস না হলে আমি খেতেই পারি না আই মিন উইদাউট মিট আই কান্ট ইভেন ইট Some people, they say like that, but we have to be careful when it comes to overeating or excessive food. Overeating is actually key. And just the way the Arabs, they say, very famous saying, al-ma'idatu baytu da, that the stomach is a source of all illnesses. Or protecting and taking care of the stomach is actually the key to all treatment and remedies.
And the other aspect is the lack of exercise, so we're not helping. So we are consuming food, but then again, we're not burning it enough.
Yes.
Lack of exercise, the importance of exercise is very least within our society.
Exactly. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi said very clearly, المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف. A strong believer physically, mentally, and spiritually is much more better than a weak believer, someone who's physically weak. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, আমাদের প্রিয় নবী মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম বলতেছেন যে একজন শক্ত মজবুত ইমানদার ব্যক্তি একজন দুর্বল ইমানদার ব্যক্তি থেকে অনেক ভালো ওয়াফি কুল্লিন খায়ের বাট প্রত্যেকের মধ্যে কিন্তু ভালো আছে ইন এভরি ওয়ান অফ দ্যার ইজ গুডনেস বাট দ্য স্ট্রঙ্গার বিলিভার ইজ বেটার to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala.
When you say better, tar mane hocche sei ibadat kintu korte parbe beshi kore so that he won't feel
and
tired and energy thakbe.
And he can serve the community, he can be strong for Islam and for his religion, for his family, for his community.
Mane social events or by social the financial socio economic system gula bhalo bhabe she
in every way a stronger believer is much better than a weaker believer. Okay. And this is when I say stronger, I mean even physical. Even sharik babeo mazboot ebong strong, yes.
So it's basically physical and spiritual. Dunote element er kothai bola hocche.
Combine korte. Okay, now again, there is a hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he says that inna min asirf an ta'kul kulla ma shtuhiyat. Or that wasting, part of the extravagance and wasting is to eat whatever someone desires to eat. Or that amar mon jana chailo ami khe fellam etake kintu israfer moddhe antarbhukto kora jete pare ejonno ulamae ikram ra bolchen jokhon amra khabar kabo amader uddeshyo hobe eta ibadat. We are eating to survive, we are eating to take care of our body, and we are eating to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala.
So basically,
now, if we eat just to enjoy, some people say we're just going to enjoy the food, then this is disliked.
Okay, so we're eating to survive, not surviving to eat food.
Exactly. And I have heard some people are saying really that, you know, I remember one person saying, people eat to live, but I live to eat.
Fair enough, yes.
So there are people like that. And this is disliked even by the Quranic statement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامِ. And this is like actually a quality of disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they eat like the cattle eat. Of course, like not all, but many. وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامُ وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًا لَهُمْ. So eat like whatever you find, and whenever, there's no time, there's no limit, there's not any size. So you eat إِنَّ مِنَ السِّرْفِ أَنْ تَأْكُلْ كُلَّ مَا اشْتُهِيَتَ. You eat everything that you desire to eat. And that's also mentioned in the book of Imam Al-Hafidh Al-Mawsili Wad-Dar Qutni. And then our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gives us more instruction when it comes to extravagance and when it comes to the wastage. Opotoy ebong shimalongoner moddhe amader priyo Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam aro bolen inna Allah kariha lakum thalathan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he disliked and detest three things for you. First of all is a qila wa qal, you know, just talking gossip. You know, this person said this person, without any evidence, without any reference. Or that shudu mane kotha eke onnoke bola gibat namima.
Ekhon to shuru hoye geche social message, social media te apni message diye dicchen ekshathe kintu hajaro manush dekhche.
And this is even worse because the sin would have been one, but now because 1,000 people are, you know, receiving your namima, your qila wa qal, the gossip, unnecessary conversation, and even things that actually cause disunity and problems amongst people, the sin's even greater.
Now, ikhane dekhi amra shobshomoy one of the biggest problem or one of the biggest challenges that we face within our society is bhul bujhabujhi theke shuru hoy.
Yes.
And then accusation without any evidence. Now, ikhane amar ekti ayatul kotha mone porche, in ja'akum fasiqun binaba'in fatabayyanu.
Yes, yes.
Now, what does Allah mean here?
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying here that if a news comes, then you must verify, especially if it's coming from a fasiq, someone who hasn't had, who doesn't have a strong faith and certainty in Allah, transgressor, shimalongon karir kach theke jodi kono khobor ashe tahole tumra etake kintu bhalo bhabe tholao, try and verify.
So when he says shimalongon, even if it comes from a transgressor, so that means even whether it be general people or any other people,
but generally, like, looking into reference is really important. Wallahi, I mean, this is so important that you can save people, you can save the community by verifying, because a lot of fitan that take place is just from qila wa qal, that, you know, fulan said, so and so person said, uni bolechen, omuk bolechen, tomuk bolechen, kintu কারো কাছে কোনো রেফারেন্স নাই আবার এটা যাকে বলবে সেগুলো আমি শুনেছি আইভ জাস্ট হার্ড
ভেরি ট্রু আবার এখানে আপনি দেখেন যদি আপনি ইসলামী অ্যাক্টিভিটিজের কথা বলেন একটা মেসেজ পেয়েছি যে আপনি এটা 10 বার পড়বেন আপনার এটা সমস্যার সমাধান হয়ে যাবে এই মেসেজটা আপনি হাজারো মানুষের কাছে আপনি ফরওয়ার্ড করে ফেলছেন উইদাউট ইভেন ভেরিফাইং whether if the hadith whether this exists.
And this is another problem, and we have people subhanallah again causing inconvenience for people. We are sending messages over messages. আমাদের কোন কোন আমাদের মধ্যে অনেক আছেন কিন্তু ছবি pictures among video gula kintu without any verification we are sending them. We are responsible for everything that we spread. আমরা কিন্তু আমরা আমাদের দায়িত্ব আছে আমাদের আমরা আমাদেরকে প্রশ্ন করা হবে কিয়ামতের ময়দানে এই জিনিসগুলো যখন আমরা স্প্রেড করব when we share these things we will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether you verified or not whether you spreaded the truth or falsehood অর্থাৎ কাযিব সত্য না মিথ্যা তুমি মানুষের সামনে তুমি স্প্রেড করেছিলে এইভাবে আল্লাহ পাক রাব্বুল আলামিন জিজ্ঞেস করবেন তবে ইন্না মিনা সিরফি আসরি আল্লাহ পাক আমাদের প্রিয় মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম বলেন ইন্না আল্লাহ কারিহা লাকুম সালাসান তিন জিনিস অপছন্দ করেছেন কিলা ওয়া কাল just talking unnecessary conversation passing the message without verification and then he said wa ida'atul mal wasting money now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ask on Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the Day of Judgment, how much money did you save? How much money did you have? The question will come and will be posed onto the person by saying, where did you get your money from? Source of income.
And how did
where did that come from? And where did you spend it? How did you spend it? When Allah gives money to me, to you, to us, all of us, He wants to see how we are spending that money. And as I said, everything is a test. Don't think that you know things are actually beyond or outside the supervision of Allah. Allah pak rabbul alamin supervision er baire kono kichu na. Uni kintu sob kichu dekhchen, observe kortechen.
Ekhane arekti kotha ache jehon Allah apnake kono mal dicchen, chakri dicchen, rizik dicchen. Ekhane kintu onnoder hok kintu roye geche.
Yes.
Amader dharona hocche, for example, I just wanted you to clarify this. Amader dharona hocche I'm working as a doctor, as an engineer, as a politician, as a banker, whatever it is you look at my source of a line of work. Now, we think this is my income. I have earned it.
Yes, we are coming to this now. So, idha'atul mal, wastage of money. I'll come to this. There's an ayah we're going to mention about that. Idha'atul mal. And then there is one more thing Prophet said that he disliked, Allah doesn't like it, is kathratu su'al, excessive questions, again, extravagance. Or that otirikto prosno.
What do you mean
and
by
this
that?
And this is a problem in many people. They will come to the scholars not to actually learn, but to ask questions to see the knowledge of the scholar. And to see like, you know, and sometimes for the sake of arguments. Like kathratu su'al, that you ask questions that are not needed, unnecessary questions. Like I sometimes hear people say, so when Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, he ate the tree, the leaves of the tree, what was the color of the leaf? অর্থাৎ মানে এই আদম আলাইহিস সালাম যখন গাছের পাতা খেয়েছে ওই পাতার কালারটা কি ছিল There is a ilm called ilmul la yanfa. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us to make this dua. He said, Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa. Oh Allah, we seek refuge with you to protect us from the knowledge that doesn't benefit. So ilmul la yanfa, we have to be very careful and we have to stay away from it. We have to completely avoid. So kathrat al-su'al is also disliked. And in our society, we have people with kathrat al-su'al, too many questions.
Now,
and unnecessary questions. But again, at the same time, su'al nisf al-ilm. You cannot just avoid the questioning. Questioning also brings a lot of knowledge.
Tarmani hotse apni bolchen to put it in context, jodi relevancy thake subject er sathe ebong apni question korchen related to the subject, then that's fine. However, if you're questioning with the intention to either degrade someone or defame someone,
or to show your knowledge,
or show you or prove your point to be more superior than the other opinion, then that needs to be
exactly, yes.
avoided.
And avoided. And this is considered as kathratu su'al, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't like. Allah opochondo koren otirikto prosno. Tarpore bola hocche, amader piyone Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also says that al-qasd, you see, we are the ummah of wasat, we are the ummah of the moderation. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said again and again, al-qasd, or that muddum punta, moderation, balance, tablughu, you will reach the destination.
But এখানে কিন্তু আরেকটা সমস্যা হচ্ছে critical point of view থেকে তার যারা হয়তো একটু strong practicing দেওয়া হচ্ছে এখন ইসলাম too much liberal হয়ে যাচ্ছে moderation
again,
money too
again,
much
again, no
everything is becoming halal.
Moderation doesn't mean liberal like you know actually compromising with the core and basic and fundamental issues of some no.
Achha.
Moderation meaning like don't do excessive. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked you to pray, but that doesn't mean that you leave your family and pray, that you pray whole day. Namaz tumi shara din porte thako kintu poribarer kono dike khyal nai, kono concentration nai. Oita kintu Allah pak rabbul alamin pochondo koren na. You have to give the due rights. Fa'ati kullavi haqqin haqqa. Give the due rights of everything duly and accordingly, according to its size and limit. So wal-qasd, Prophet said, wal-qasd, or that iqtisad means like the moderation, middle path, tablughu, you'll reach the destination. You know, sometimes it's not either quantity. Sometimes it's just how you're doing and how you're balancing it out, how you are, just like sometimes, like, you know, some people become too loyal to their parents, which is good. We should obey our parents, but then forget the wives and partners.
Or the other way around.
And the other way around as well. And some people are too inclined to the wives and forgetting the parents. Like, you know, I don't care about my mom and dad because they did this, 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 that to me. And this is the reason why they are completely careless about their parents. So al-qasd is very, very important in this religion of Islam. Now, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Noble Quran, وَآتِ ذَا الْقُرْبَى. Now, the point, Brother Qamar, you've mentioned earlier, that the rights of the poor, rights of the relatives on our wealth. And sometimes we think, you know, the money that you earn, amra je sampad gulo amra orjon korchi eta shudhu amar credit. No, hadith er moddhe praman ache je onek shomoy apnar poribarer kichu loker luck diye Allah pak rabbul alamin oder bhaggo diye apnake
fortune diye apnake
chesta. Yes, because somebody in your, maybe somebody in your family less privileged, someone may be like,
ar amader to ache erokom attyoshor achei hoyto deshe ache ni amader attyo
less able,
less able financially, socially, ebong amra dekhi they struggle even to get their children married off. But amader hoyto nije blood related attyoshor achen they are in the country of origin, but then again, we don't even look up to them. We don't even inquire about them.
And see, this is the problem. Silatul Rahim and ties of kinship, we spoke very in details in our previous programs. But yes, وَآتِدَ الْقُرْبَحَ. Sometimes you get the money that you're earning, actually, it's because of somebody else in your family. It's just not because of you. And it's mentioned in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the rights of the poor and relatives in your mal, don't deprive them. অন্যদেরকে তুমি এটাকে মাহরুম করো না, অন্যকে অন্যদেরকে তুমি এটা থেকে ডোন্ট কিপ দ্যাম অ্যাওয়ে, বঞ্চিত করো না. ইয়েস, ওয়াতি দাল কুরবা হাক্কা ওয়াল মিসকিন, গিভ দ্য রাইট অফ দ্য মিসকিন এন্ড দ্য রিলেটিভস, ওয়াবনি সাবিল এন্ড দ্য পাসেস বাই এন্ড সামবডি হু ইজ স্ট্রেঞ্জার এন্ড নিডি. এন্ড দেন আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা ওয়ালা তুবাদদির তাবযীরা, ডোন্ট ওয়েস্ট, ডোন্ট বি এক্সট্রাভাগেন্ট, অপচয় করো না. وَلَا تُبَذِّرْ تَبْذِيرَ كَرْمَتْهِ إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Verily, obviously, the mubadhirin jara opocho jara koren ora hotche shaytaner bhai. Keno Allah pak rabbul alamin bolen opocho jara koren opocho karira shaytaner bhai? Keno Allah pak rabbul alamin bolechen? Mufassirin ikram, the scholars of tafsir, the commentators of the Noble Quran, they say that one of the major problems of the shaytan is inkar an ni'am, or that rejecting the ni'mah. Like, he has been given so much, people say, like, you know, I haven't been given anything. Or that taka koto jinish dewa hoyeche tarpor she bole dewa hoy nai. Eta kintu inkar ebong juhud hocche shaytaner eta ekti sifat ba alamat. So wala tubaddir innal mubadhirina kanu ikhwana shayatin. Allah pak rabbul alamin amaderke jokhon sampad den ebong ei sampad ke amra jokhon etake amra value dei na, we don't appreciate that mal and we waste them. And we waste, and we do anything and everything with this money. We spend so much money in our clothes, branded clothes, and you see, like, you know, how
designers
much people
clothes, yeah, designer unnecessary, clothes, unnecessary,
unnecessary. Okay. Yes, and this is a way of actually inkarun ni'am, rejecting and denying the ni'am of Allah. And this is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said these two qualities of someone's waste is like the quality or a sifa of a shaytan. Innal mubadhirina kanu ikhwana shayatin. The wasters are the brothers of shaytan.
Now, you have the other flip side to it is, I'm talking about rejecting the ni'amah. Mm-hmm. We have, jokhon kono calamity ashe, shathe shathe thon amra bolbo, but challenge ashe, ami to namaz pori, roza rakhi, why me?
Yes.
Then why me? So how would exactly you tackle
now,
that?
No, this is again like it's a sign of again inkar on ni'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests everybody, and this is a very important thing. We have to be very careful how we respond to our and how we deal with our problems. We can't just say why is it me, because you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
we should be thankful
everyone.
And grateful
and for the good things that he gave us. Also, we don't realize in our society we waste many, many things. We waste water, which is one of the very important source. And some of us, we have bath for hours. And even in wudu, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, don't waste your water even in wudu. And he said, even if you are making wudu in front of or in a flowing river, then don't waste your water in wudu. Kintu amader onek kintu pani opochoy kore thaken, oneke electricity opochoy kore thaken. Just because you're in a hotel in a public place, that doesn't mean that you waste the energy, you waste water, you waste the tissues, And some of us, we see, subhanAllah, like people take tissues, like, you know, there's not any limit in the usage of tissues and wipes.
And even again, petrol, unnecessary wastage of petrol, again, driving unnecessarily.
Look at the source of the tissues and wipes. These actually come from tree, natural resources. Allah's, these are from Allah's ni'mah. These are from Allah's creation. And we are, we've been given responsibility to take care of the creation of Allah and to waste and extravagant when it comes to the consume the ni'mah of Allah or the creation of Allah the Almighty.
Jazakallah khair, Shaykh. I would love to continue much more, but time is up. And inshallah, thank you ever so much for sharing your thoughts and knowledge and coming onto the program.
Allahu barik feekum. Jazakumullah khairan.
With this, my dear viewers, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. The topic was wastage. Amra shunechi, and we have learned from this program is, alhamdulillah, there is no problem with enjoying the ni'mah that Allah has blessed and bestowed upon us through halal sources and income. But the question is, how do we utilize it? How do we spend it? How do we make sure that we are accountable one day, inshallah, for those kind of blessings that Allah has given us? And most important, that Shaykh have touched upon the importance of relatives, the importance of family ties, and it's our responsibility, the people who are close to us, blood relative or extended families that were less able and less fortunate. If Allah has given us the ni'mah, we should look after them. And this program, we haven't given any health advice. The Shaykh have clearly mentioned that if you have any issues that you want to medically find out or understand, please feel free to consult a local practice, the local GP, and inshallah take feedback and take the necessary advice from the professionals. With this, that's all from me for tonight. Inshallah, looking forward to see you again in our next episode. Till we meet again, subhanakallahumma wa hamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair, Shaykh.